Cookies.
Today, we're going to bring the Scepter. It's a 27Q. It's a 27-inch monitor. It's 1920 by 1080. Now, this is a refresh rate of 240 hertz. We're going to take a look at it. We're going to game some on it. We're going to test out the speakers and other items there. So, if you guys notice, I killed off the lights in here so you guys could just concentrate and look at the actual monitor itself. Now, the bezel is really thin on every single corner. The top, they're basically the same. It's a curved monitor. We're going to put the actual curve ratio in there in the description too. Now, all the buttons are basic. They're all in the corner, and we're going to go over a little bit right now. And the audio is a little high too, so we're going to put it 100% so you guys could hear the speaker on it. So we're going to test it out and see what you get when you get some of this. So let's go ahead and start. We're going to go, if you want to control the volumes, you could use the arrows right away. Either arrow will give you a control of the actual audio on the actual monitor. So either arrow to start with will give you actual control of the audio, right? All right, we're going to hit the menu button. On the menu button, it's going to bring it up, and you hit the menu again for enter, right? And then you could use the arrows to go up and down. You have preset, volume, source, blue light, shift, and FreeSync Premiere, all right? So we have all that set up. So we're going to go back to menu. Well, actually go back to E to get to the main screen. So we go to E, and then we'll go back to picture. We hit the menu button. Under picture, you got preset, 50% sharp, and multiple windows. We could turn it on if we have multiple systems on. It's up to you. And you got other options in here that are you can't see them right now because they're not, the functions are not available to the system or is not connecting with the FreeSync. But you could enable some of them later down the line. So we're going to go back to E, and we go down to colors, and then we hit the menu. And then the menu button, you have normal, gamma, tint, saturation, and then blue light shift. So you got plenty of options in this system. So we go back to E again, and we got the last one, which we're going to go see the last one, system. On this one, overdrive, FreeSync, Premiere, sleep mode, black cover light, language, OSDH position, OSD timer, OSD transparency, and then we have volume, mute, and reset. The reset will factor reset anything you change in the system. You can always go back to factor reset and it will resync everything. Now we're gonna go out of here. That's pretty much all the systems. Now the E itself, we're gonna go back to E. Now E, if you have different connections to the actual monitor, you hit the E and it gets a display. Right now we're not on display port. We're actually on HDMI, and I put an HDMI 2.1 cable on it, so I can make sure it's not gonna affect any transfer rate or anything like that. So we wanna make sure we got the best connection to it too. All right, just to let you guys know, this thing comes off here, and this is where the actual mount goes in there, right? What you need to do is remove the screws in here so it could give you the ability to have these four corners to become the actual for the portable hand, for a mechanical hand. The only thing is that you got to make sure that it's going to fit the right size, because they do have converters for it. The thing is, I like the best thing, I like it when it clips on pretty simple. You hold the button down and just clip it in there, and that's pretty much it does it. Now, one thing about this system, it all lights up. Everything lights up in the back. If you guys notice, it just turned on right now. All the lights turn on. It turns red right now. They don't blink. They don't stay anything. They just pretty much stay solid. It's their color, kind of like their part of their logo. One thing I like about it, it's eye-catching. And it lights up in the back of the actual monitor. If you have a dark room, you're going to see that in the back. So we're underneath of it, if you guys can see. Right here, we have the audio for your headsets. You plug it in. It's a 3.5 jack. Because the speakers on here are not the strongest or the best, but you could actually, if you don't have that, you have an option to connect it and it'll sound a lot better. Now you have your display port, and then you have three HDMIs, 3, 2, and 1, and then you got your power cord connection, of course. Then right next to it, you have access to all the buttons itself. You got plenty of ventilation the speakers are on the sides. Everything runs really smooth if you're setting up. Now, the best way to use this monitor is if you have it in front of you, because it's made, it curves around you. Setting up the actual stand is easy. It comes with the screws. They give you a screwdriver. They give you the manual and everything else. And their support is pretty awesome.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and record from a camera, so you can see how fast the gaming is. On this one, we're running a pretty high frames resolution, frames per second. So let's go ahead and go into the training course and go ahead and ready up. Before we ready up, well, let's just go ahead and start. I just wanted you to see how fast and how loud this thing is right now. Our FPS just dropped a little bit, but we're still running at 60. Right now, 270 maximum we're going. We're gonna be running there, and you guys can see the graphics on it. All right, so here's a frame per second. Right now, we're running at 280, 220. That's not bad.
.6 of you are not subscribers in my channel. I hope that the content helps you out and that you find it very useful. And I hope you hit the like and subscribe.